This is me.
Just kidding. This is me.
My name is Amanda, and welcome to my podcast where I will be talking about pop culture, music, film, drama, and fan videos.
Hello, and welcome back to my channel, Always Popular. I'm Amanda, your host, and let's jump into the last episode of the anniversary series. For a while now, I have been celebrating many pop culture anniversaries from TV shows to album releases. Today, once again, I will transform us back into the 90s. There are many people that want to relive the 90s, and I can understand because of one reason why. To see this boy band perform live. So this is 25th anniversary of NSYNC's debut album, NSYNC, and it consisted of five members: lead singers Justin Timberlake, JC Chazay, Joey Fatone, Lance Bass, and most importantly, founder
It's Kirkpatrick.
NSYNC was first released internationally in Germany on May 26, 1997, and then the following year in America in March of 98. They had a similar marketing strategy to their peers, the Backstreet Boys, and went the international route.
However, their first album was considered a flop because they failed to top the top 40 or the Billboard 200. I find it hard to believe because it felt like their music was
everywhere.
However, due to one performance that the Backstreet Boys pulled out of, which was a Disney special, it gave them an opportunity to market their music. With that one performance, it changed everything. For this album in particular, it had multiple hit songs like I Want You Back, Tearin at My Heart, Here We Go, I Drive Myself Crazy, For the Girl That Has Everything, and God Must Have Spent a Little More Time on You. Surprisingly, Tearin at My Heart was not their first single, like I thought it was. Actually, it was I Want You Back, and mainly because it was released in Germany. Anyway, most of their success mainly happened in Germany first and became an overnight success, and then eventually led to well-known worldwide success that they have today.
I Want You Back and Tearin at My Heart both managed to reach the top 10 in Germany, and the album went to number 1. Overseas, the album did a lot better after the Disney special. The album skyrocketed to number 2 on the Billboard charts. Millions of people wanted to request their music on the radio and became a boy band hysteria everywhere. It became the fifth best-selling album of 1998 with over 4.4 million copies sold. Also, the album spent more than 100 weeks at number 2 on the Billboard as well and is now a diamond-selling album in the U.S. with over 10 million copies sold. Most of the singles were certified silver or gold, which is quite interesting considering
it talked about their music
was and still is today. It's also crazy because people still listen and talk about their music today, and they made such a huge impact in a short period of time. Just like their peers, like Hanson, Backstreet Boys, and even 98 Degrees,
they did
all of this without the help of social media.
If they did
have social media, they would have been more commercially successful. They sold over 9 million copies, and worldwide, the album has sold over 15 million copies. This is also quite interesting because I expected their songs to be a lot more commercially successful. Not a single song went platinum, so I find that very hard to believe. So I guess there's a big difference between popularity and
commercial success.
Debut album was still successful regardless. It's still one of the most popular pop albums in history of music. It put the band in the record books and made them pop legends from just their first album. It also ranked 137th best album of all time on the Billboard 200 albums of all time. And the group has become the third best-selling boy band of all time. Here are some honorable mentions from their album. We all really need love. There's a hand with you, and I would give everything I own. In pop culture a lot as well. Before I go, I do have some other pop culture
news.
So this has been recently in the headlines just recently, and I found this out by rewatching one of my older favorite
childhood movies.
So this is on the sadder side of things. Anyway, if you grew up watching The Parent Trap, specifically the 1998 version that launched Lindsay Lohan's career, you might recognize this actress.
Call me Aunt Vicky.
Is Joanna Barnes. She actually was in the original Parent Trap that was released back in the 1960s, which I didn't even know about until I researched her because I was recently just watching the 1998 version of the Parent Trap, and I just found out that she passed away. So right now it's a very big deal, and a lot of people are grieving and missing her.
So rest in peace, Joanna.
Anyway, so this wraps up this episode. Once again, thanks for listening and watching, and you'll hear me in the next episode.